Hey YouTube, Rob's back. An update. I've got more than 3,000 subscribers now, and I thank each and every one of you for sticking with me. I've had a few health problems that have slowed me down, slowed down my smoking, for sure, but I still smoke a little bit, and I'm going to light up right now with one I made myself. And I'm going to have some videos about making your own, and they'll be coming up in the next week or two. I'm making them right now. So, here's a product of some of my work earlier this morning, and I'll enjoy it. It's great tasting because I selected the tobacco that went into it, and that makes all the difference. Just don't want to buy the cheapest stuff you can get or just want one thing. You can mix things. This is a mix of two different tobaccos. And I had all my equipment and the tobacco out, and it took me a grand total of 15 seconds to make this. So for those of you that don't smoke very much, this is one of the ways to go. The smoke nannies, however, up the taxes on this loose tobacco because they realized that you could make cigarettes, you used to be able to make cigarettes for one quarter of the price of ready-made cigarettes that most people buy. As soon as they understood that, then they raised the taxes on the loose tobacco. So that you really don't save a whole lot of money now, not nearly as much as you used to. So, nannies do what nannies do, and if you keep electing them, you'll get more. And the news today was people in Europe saying with the passing of plain packaging regulations in Great Britain, United Kingdom, that they were going to go forward with even more regulations with the whole idea, and they admit this, the whole idea is to down the road as soon as they can, ban smoking. Totally just ban it. Forbid it. And that's what's coming if they get their way. And they want to do this over the next 10 to 15 years. And they want to do it worldwide, not just in one country or a group of countries. They want to do it worldwide. So each thing that they implement is an experiment, and then if it succeeds, then they do the same thing in another country and use that as a template. See how the public reacts. And since the majority of the public doesn't smoke, hey, they don't care. But soon enough, the nannies will ban something that they like, and they won't like it. And they'll complain, but they'll be in a minority. And that's how it works. So yeah, that's the way the system's set up now, to take away your freedoms and individual liberties, and do what the nannies want you to do. It's difficult to live under that situation, and whenever they've tried it in the past, they've created nothing but a black market. It's failed. An example here in the United States, of course, is the prohibition on alcoholic beverages of all types. And they just created a huge industry of underground production of alcoholic beverages and the sale of them in secret. A lot of people went to jail, of course. A lot of people got fined. A lot of lives were ruined, and people still wanted their alcoholic beverages, and eventually the nannies gave it up. Now there are many more tools to monitor what you do, all the things that you write on the computer, everything you say on the telephone or your cell phones, everything is now being collected. So, it's much, much harder to be free. matrix is being created. The matrix already exists. So I want to thank all my subscribers. Thanks for sticking with me. Thanks for watching. But most of all, enjoy life the way you choose and be free.